Now the second question. This second question is for graphical method, second method approach, slope method, how to solve the same problem by slope method to get better idea of understanding in this method. Now, my first step is to convert equation number 1 and equation number 2 in this form, y equal to mx plus c. This is straight line equation. So first I am taking the equation number 1 and converting it into this form. So I am putting this y equal to what? Minus 2x plus 7. This is in this form. Now I compare y equation, this equation with this, and find out the value of m. My m value is what? Minus 2 divided by 1. And what is my c value? C value is what? 7. Now I am going to plot the graph. So in graph, I start drawing with this point, c is equal to 7. So where the 7 value lie? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is the point from where my straight line must pass. So this is your c value. The total value up to 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. So this is my c value. Okay, 7. Now slope method, this is negative sign, that means downward motion. This negative represents downward motion. How much? Again, this is minus 2 and this is 1. Means 2 downward, 1 rightward. So starting from this point, I move downward 2 step. 1, 2. Why 2 step? Because of this 2 numerator value. So 1, 2 and then move 1 rightward. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is the second point. Again, 2 step downward, 1 step rightward. Second point. 2 step downward, 1 step rightward. 2 step downward, 1 step rightward. So with the help of these all points, you draw a straight line. So I am just drawing this straight line. Okay. Which, this straight line represents 2x plus y equal to 7. So for this equation, this will be my straight line, and this straight line passed from this point. This is my C point. So what is my C value? C is y intercept, where the straight line must pass. Okay. Now convert the second equation into this form. So if I am converting this equation, I will get y equal to minus 3x plus 9. Okay. Y this side positive, 9 on left side positive. So this is my second equation, and second equation if you compare with your result, so you will get what? M is equal to how much? Minus 3 by 1, and C equal to what? 9. Okay. Now where is my 9 value? 9 positive, it means I need to extend this graph. So this is 7, 8, 9. So this is my point for this equation. Okay, now again this is negative. How much negative? 3 downward, 1 rightward. So from this point I move 3 downward. So 1, 2, 3 and 1 rightward. So this is my first point. Again you need to go 3 downward because of this negative sign. So 1, 2, 3 and 1 rightward. Now you will get a common point again. I repeat again, this is my starting point, right? 9. Then you need this value. This is negative means downward stroke, downward motion. So downward motion, how much? This value, 3 step downward. So 1, 2, 3 step downward, and this one is rightward stroke, 1 step rightward. Then again you repeat again and again, 1, 2, 3, 1 right, 1, 2, 3, 1 right, 1, 2, 3, 1 right, like this. So this is 1, 2, 3, 1 right, 1, 2, 3, 1 right, then 1, 2, 3, 1 right. That means this point. Now, this is my point. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So with the help of this line, now this is the line which represents this equation. Minus 3x minus y equal to minus 9. And this line is cut. This y intersection at this point, so this will be my c value for equation number 2. This is C value for question number 2, this is C value from question number 1. But both line must pass through these point and both have one common intersection point, this one. And this will be my solution. So, what is the coordinate of this point? 1, 2. This is 2x and 1, 2, 3. 3, right. So, this is my x equal to 2 and y equal to 3. So, this will be my solution. X equal to 2, y equal to 3 is the solution of this equation. So, this is very simple step to find out the common point if you know the concept of a straight line. What is my m value? What is my c value? What this negative sign represent? What the positive sign represent? What is 3 by 1? What is 3 by 1? Suppose if you have, I just give you additional information anywhere. If you get, suppose m is equal to 2 by 3, suppose you will get this and you will get minus 3 by 4. So how you will proceed? So from here, 2 step downward and 3 step rightward. This is negative means downward direction. 3 step downward, 4 step rightward. Here 2 positive means 2 step upward. So this 2 means 2 upward, 3 rightward. Minus means 3 downward, this 4 rightward. So this is how you approach, how you go forward and right direction. Why I am only shifting one direction rightward? Because my numerator is only 1. But if your numerator is 3, it means 3 rightward direction. If your numerator is 4, sorry, denominator is 4, it means it's 4 rightward direction. And this numerator represent upward step or downward step with this sign, right? So this is the stroke upward or downward, and this denominator represent how much you step in downward direction. Here, since this is 1, this is 1, that's why I just take 1 step in rightward direction. I think it's clear to you. One question I am going to give you with this concept also, so that you will clear with overall approach of slope method to solve linear equations.